5 o'clock on a May morning. The sun's not even up yet. And I'm out to stalk my first roll book with deer expert Richard Pryor. Yes, beautiful.
Find a good chance.
Good. Look, I'm looking forward to this.
Well, something different. There we are. Put a cartridge in the rifle straight away. Because you never know when you're going to run across something. And they tend to pick the click up.
How many do I want in? About three?
Yes. Three enough? Yes, three for bucks, four for does. I usually put in the rifle. I don't know why. And the thing is, we have to look very carefully because we're trying to manage the roe very carefully on this estate. And what we want is the surplus ones. It's not just anything, so we look very, very carefully and see what we can find. It's either very old or very young. That's the sort of general rule.
Which direction are we going in?
I think we'd go off up there. It's the wind suits. And we'll see what we can find in the wood at the top. We need one of them.
It's a bit still. Does that make a difference?
Well, there's always a little bit of wind. And it's just puffing in our face a bit. So I think that'll do very well.
OK.
Right, on we go. Come on, Wiggs. Heel up.
I don't think any shooting's the same without the dog.
And it's surprising how much you'll point when you can't see a thing. You'll suddenly say, there is one. And
well, most dogs are exactly the same. I mean, mine, when you've done shooting a long time, you then realise you've got to trust your dog.
Yes.
Particularly rough shooting and things like that. Yes, when they say there's something there, there's something there.
Yeah. And it's half the pleasure, really. Fantastic bird song. There's a tree bend here. Let's have a look. So there's been a buck in it. This is one thing you don't want in a tree bank, it's a rope.
That's a tree bank. That's for replacement trees for the forest.
Well, it's really against the replacement for the hooligan.
It's getting a bit thick in there now, to see.
Just beyond. What we must look out for. Two yelling bucks. Cherry trees look pretty. It's coming into flower. Wig and gale.
So movement in there, but it's a hare, I think.
Well, you've got to look for every movement. Because it'll only be a flick of an ear or something which is a horizontal line and something which is normally vertical. Just coming up. Just the right moment.
They do, don't they?
Yeah.
Look huge.
Feathers puffed out. Now, I think we'll go down here and look out into the field.
There's one in the field.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I think that's a doe.
Not sure.
Come a yard my way. A yard. See ya. dog says there's something.
He's probably 4 or 5, I think.
But they don't.
So we'd be looking for an older buck or a younger yearling?
Well, one or the other, yes.
He looks well in the sunshine, doesn't he?
Doesn't he?
Just beginning to get his summer coat. He's just down the back of his neck. You see the way they go up to the hedge to feed. They're really browsing animals.
Well, that's probably because they've sprayed the field, like say.
He's scraping. It's territorial marking, you see.
Is that what he's doing?
Brushing his antlers up and down on the bushes and scraping with his forefoot. And that leaves scent.
Well, we're not going to get very close to him, are we, for a shot?
He's definitely one to be left.
He would be in the range that we don't want to shoot.
Yes, very much so.
A middle-aged buck.
Plenty of fallow deer and pregnant does about, but no shootable bucks yet. 100 years ago, the roe had just about disappeared from the south of England. Foresters hated them for the tree damage they did, and they were snared and shotgunned nearly to extinction. But a few people stood up for them, and they were reintroduced into some areas, and since then they've been a real success story. With proper management by stalkers like Richard Pryor, they've become fairly common, although you've got to be up and about early to see them.
In the field, the left-hand side.
Turned the wrong way, didn't he?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, he's doing it.
But it's not a safe shot in there, because the sawmill's behind.
Carefully to the corner, and he may give us a chance. Hey, Granny's footsteps. Don't move when he's looking. Another one behind. No,
he's moving this way.
He'll be out in the field.
Yeah, but he's moving this way. Yes,
go out to the corner. Decent chance. anything when it suits you.
Did I miss him? Well, he's a fair way off for me.
About 80 yards.
Hey?
80 yards. Bad luck.
Well, I missed him clean.
Feel you were steady on him?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I was steady on him. That was bad. I once gave away a penalty in an FA Cup semi-final, and I felt a bit like I do now. Even the dog must think I'm a right Burke. Richard never said anything. He's too polite. But I know what he must be thinking. I couldn't blame the rifle. It was spot on yesterday when I sighted it in. The one satisfaction is I missed him clean. I went for a neck shot, knowing it would either be a miss or a kill. He was a fair way off, but no excuses.
In fact, there are two.
Let me see. Yeah, there's one on the left.
Don't you see? Is the one on the right, the back line showing. It's around the tree. Two yearlings. Just what we want.
There's one, the one to the right I can see best.
That's fine. Well, now take him when you get the chance. It's a safe shot. Just... Do you want the other stick?
Just need a yard. No, I'll be all right with this one.
Okay. They've not seen us. They don't know we're there.
I don't know if I hit him.
Can't
Do you see him?
No, I can't see. The other one's gone off. It was the right-hand one you've fired at.
Yeah. I must have hit him.
Just give him a minute. And then we'll go up. Go up.
I'll be very surprised if I missed it.
Well, we'll see. Ha! You got it. There it is.
I got it?
Yep.
Good.
Well done.
Good.
Now, we'll go on with the dog. And we'll just send her to absolutely make sure. I think it's dead. Now then. Wiggs?
Did it tend to get up and run again if they're not...
I lost. Where is it? Go on. Good girl. Find it. There's a clever dog. Well, it's just an insurance, you know.
Yeah.
Well, you've got it. There it is.
Oh, yeah. Good.
Splendid.
I'm glad of that.
So am I.
This one.
Clever dog. There we are. Oh, what a clever dog.
She's very keen on him, isn't she?
Yes, she is. They're just the sort of buck we wanted. Couldn't be better.
Oh, aye. Where did I get him? There.
Just about right.
Just a little bit high, that. A bit far back and a bit high.
Never knew what hit him. And that's how we like it to be. Right, sit, Wiggs. Sit. Good girl. Well, that's splendid.
This is one of the yearlings, you call?
Yes, that's one of the surplus that there's always too many, and those are the ones that do the damage.
So you take the yearlings out and the older ones?
Yes, we like to leave the middle-aged. The more middle-aged I am, the more I like to leave middle-aged bucks. You know? But these are the ones that really like the farmer.
You see where he came out?
His lambs. Yeah, that couldn't be...
Oh, he's come out just above the vertebrae.
Is it weak? Yep. That's it.
Oh, he's dead as a dodo.
Yeah, and there we are. Yelling might be 2 years old. We have a look at his teeth in a minute. Fine.
Well?
Well, well done indeed.
I'm glad I got him because I was after that first one, I wasn't too happy.
That's your first buck.
And there was a lot of cover in between.
Yeah.
I never saw him fall. Once I fired, I never saw him fall at all. Maybe that's with a gun coming up.
No, well, neither did I. I saw the other one go off, and I never saw this one at all. He just went absolutely straight down.
So what do you do now? You bleed him and grog him?
Yes, the sooner the better. And that makes the better venison, and good eating he'll be. So...
Are there many of these about around here? I mean, we've seen a few this morning, but...
I've seen a fair few, actually. But, yes, there are a lot. They've built up over the last 15 years since they came here first. And, now, there's no predators, you see. There's no wolves, no lynxes. And apart from a few fawns that the foxes get, which doesn't really count for anything, there's a terrific surplus. And the last thing we want to see is them dying of starvation or disease, which is the other thing that'll happen. So we've got to step in and manage them. And we try and do it as humanely and thoughtfully as we can. But I must say, I like to see a buck go down like that. It's a relief.
Yeah, can I hold up for you?
No, that's fine. Range back a bit. No, we'll get him out clean if we can. I always like to look as carefully as I can at them because you can learn a lot about the health of the beast by, you know, how many parasites he's got. Because the yearlings tend to get quite a lot of parasites on them if there's too many. So one looks at the lungs to just make sure what they're suffering from, if anything. Mostly they're very, very healthy. But the diseases they do get are diseases mostly of overpopulation, and they mostly aren't the things that farm animals get.
Well, I look forward to a bit of the liver. Because it's very, very nice.
Yes, it's good eating, actually. And nice. I must say, there it is. And I think we've got a duty to... If we're going to shoot a beast, we ought to make the best use of every bit of it that we possibly can. And the liver's very good eating.
Do you use the heart as well?
Yeah. Heart makes the most beautiful mince. So we'll hang on to that. We'll put that in the polythene bag in a minute. And the kidneys, of course. There's one. And we'll find the other one. We can.
So what happens to this animal now? Do we divvy it up and take it home?
The sooner it gets hanging up and cooling, the better venison it'll be. And venison, of course, is sold, and that goes back into the conservation of the woods. That's what I like about this.
So this will be sold to a butcher who'll sell it, and then you take the proceeds, and it goes back into the husbandry of the rest of them.
That's right, yes. I mean, the deer do damage. That's the trouble. You know, they eat trees for a living. And so the money that the venison brings in is put back against the amount of damage that the deer do.
Good. I'll give you a hand to put this in your bag, then,
yes, please.
I've got cramp in my knee with you and I'm watching you.
It's just a tube, and we'll slide him in. That's it.
I see what you mean now, yeah.
I mean, in it
so
goes.
So if I reach in the other end and pull, you'll push.
Yeah.
No, it's not open at this end.
Oh, right, we'll slide him straight in. We put both into the bag. Mind out, Wig, you're in the way. Now what we want to do is to bend him up.
Will he go into there?
Surprising, isn't it? Don't lift him up. And if one puts them in the polythene, they don't want to stay in there very long. No.
This is just for transportation back to the car. Wimley, he's got his foot out here.
Surprising how small an animal it is, really.
We've not forgotten anything.
It's easy enough to leave your knife behind. I haven't left a dog behind.
I don't know how I got to be the one to carry this thing, but as I shot it, I suppose it's right that I do.
Well, I think you ought to get a venison dinner at the end of it. Anyway, it's a marvellous moment when everything's gone right. You haven't got to be quiet anymore.